I have read the Act, the Teaching Hospitals Act. I have a serious problem with Section 37. That's one of the things I would tell my minister. That Section 37.
Of what?
Of the of the Act that established the Ghana
Teaching
Hospitals. Yes, Ghana Health Service and the Teaching Hospitals. Yes. That Act, I think it's Act 525, yes. You realize that when it comes to the teaching hospitals, the board is composed of one person who is a non-executive to be the chairman, and then all the others are various departmental heads, and then a few, I think three others, appointed by the president. The question is, if we want proper corporate governance structure, should we have the executives themselves also constituting the board? Who do they report to? I don't know if I'm not starting a controversy yet, but I think that's one of the things.
I don't think it's a controversy. It's a challenge that
yes, it's a big
generally
challenge.
We must have. We tend to, in many of our boards, and it's parliament that does that, executive members are also members of the board, so who's supervising whom? It's a big challenge that we have to look at again.
Mr. Chairman, I think that in various corporate institutions, we have maybe the executive, the chief executive being a member of the board, that's understandable. But where in a situation we have all the other, and indeed they are employees, all other employees being the board members, how do they report? That's one of the things I think we must find ways of changing that act.